Hello and welcome back to part two. It was really enjoyable, the first section. The first time we played, everyone's on 100%. I've got to start managing the games because I'm going to have to play my strongest team against Zaragoza, and then we're going to have to play a weakened team at home against Paxos Ferreira. I want to get through the UEFA Cup tie. Let me check everyone's back. Alphonso Martins has started to pick up now. Five assists. Slowed down with Rui Bento though. He just had like a really strong start. Santa Maria is back, which is good news. Should I play him instead of Cuadrado? But he did play well that game. Let's put Hanush on the bench. Might drop Tello into the B team for a little bit just to get some football. I should have Luis Diaz on the bench instead of Felipe, who's struggled a little bit. Has he got better as captain? Yep. So come on. Let's improve this away form. Not a good start to the episode when our star striker gets injured. And we haven't scored when we was on top, and now we go 1-0 down. A lot of shots off target as well. Nicolai does equalise straight on half time now. Nicolai again. No one's really playing badly. Could bring Hanish on for maybe Yao Pinto. But I think I'll leave it. It was an away win, that's good. And we're top with Porto. I've got a game in hand though. It's important we get through against Zaragoza. It's going to be a tough game. We did play our, we have been playing our B team in the UEFA Cup though. I'm gonna play my strongest team in that game and try and get the win. Porto win again. We thumped them, but they won every other game since, or throughout the season, I mean. But we've got to go to Porto later on in the season, and we have to go to Benfica as well. And we did get that really strong away win at Boa Vista. I didn't check how long. I've re-put the scouts back out because that first scouting mission didn't go very well. We just got like ones and two stars. They've probably all been snapped up now, so we'd have to wait till next season. Out for a month. Out for 3 weeks. We do have Hanush on the bench, though. This is our strongest team. Yeah, he was. Non-wibbled anyway. I was just checking. Zaragoza. Let's go. It's a great start. are disallowed. Hopefully that doesn't cost us. But Nikolai makes it too. Alfonso Martins makes it three. I'll bring on some subs at 60. There'll still be a risk if they get a goal back though, Zaragoza. They've had a disallowed goal. So, oh, fuck's sake, now Yao Pinto's injured. This is risky, because we're going to be so weak down the flanks. Well, weaker, I mean. But looks like we've done it anyway. They're not going to get three goals in 5 minutes. But we've picked up injuries. God, I could have done with him not being injured, just for a backup striker on the bench. But that was a really strong away win. But I could get away with a weakened team at home against Pacos Ferreira. Well, we hope anyway. So I could play Lourenco. Hopefully they're not too knackered. It is a 3 day rest. He was the main one which was most knackered. I can change. It's only Sal Pinto really that needs changing. I could play Hanush. But then I've got no backup forward. Still no goal. Before half time, come on. Nikolai. Piss off. Disallowed. That was their only shot of the game so far. But that's the danger when you play so attacking. The AI is going to be far more dangerous when they have an attack, because it means they've got three. Now Bento is injured. Luis Diaz and Hugo Vianoff on Lourenco. Well, it was comfortable in the end, but. And then we got, at least we've got a 14-day break now, so hopefully some of our players come back. Days. Salpino's, what's he, 97. That's a tough tie. Like getting Zaragoza and PAO, it's so early on in the UEFA Cup. Usually you get like some crappy teams early on, which makes it easier for rotation. But when you're forced to play a strong team against those kinds of opposition. But there was a huge difference between my strongest team winning away at Zaragoza 3-0 and then playing my B team at home and only drawing 0-0. And we was outplayed and lucky to get a draw. It looks like a two-horse race. Benfica are like miles behind already. Well, we smashed them at home. Two weeks. 10 days. Alfonso Martins back in, but our strongest team. Sure, they're playing a 4-4-2. Piss off. Equalised straight away, Yalpino back from injury. It just feels like we have so many shots. We just. Yalpino again. Piss off. That's the danger with the tactic though. I can't really complain, but it's just annoying. Especially when we're missing so many chances. Are we going to get the last minute winner? Goalkeeper lets down. I'll put in Thiago now. PAO at home. So we're going to have to play our strongest team in the home game. And then rotate slightly for the league game. He's averaging, I think his goals and assists will go up. But look at his average rating though, it's so high. It's not as if he's playing badly. But Yao Pino is just a more complete player, right? That's why he does so well, and he can do the defensive and attacking responsibility. It's a tough game though. PAO are always good on it. I'm surprised they usually do well in the Champions League in the first season. They're always in their second group phase most of the time. Disallowed. Barbosa is injured. Where is he? See, I did want to take off Kazuma, but he's playing well. Can bring on Tonito though. We need a second goal to take away to Greece. I was gonna say I thought they'd score then because they got through with Elisa Deby. At least we didn't concede an away goal. We basically need to fully rotate our home to Firenze. So we're fresh for the return fixture against PAO. I think is it PAO the day after? Come on, Braga. Oh no, that's the kind of game you need Porto to drop points in. Especially when Braga are flying. Let's keep Thiago in then. I'm going to have to risk playing Phil Babb, Hugo, Santa Maria. It's Bento knackered, but 99. Pozim is fucked because he's young. So we have to play Luis Diaz. Barbosa is injured. I'm going to play Hanesh. Alfonso Martins. Well, I could play Alfonso Martins wide left and then play Tonito through the middle. Oh, yeah, he's still fit. Call up AU because Yardell's out for a little while longer. Was Diago's passing only 11? Isn't there Carrez? He's only 11 as well. What about Texera? Wow, Hugo Viana retrained really quickly. Oh, Sal Pino's only 89. Well done, Nicola. He's such a tank on this Yelp, and I wasn't expecting him to be that good in this role, not get that many goals. Nikolai again. Oh shit, yeah. Should have just left him, but there's only 9 minutes left, so. We got, it's always good when you get a way of rotating. And then we got the Portuguese Cup. I might play AU in this game. Nikolai's still 100% though. But yeah, I want to keep him fresh for the return game. Could put Salpinto back in. Just don't want to get knocked out on this banana skin. Actually, I'll leave Thiago in. He's been solid since I've put him as number one. Do I risk playing Diogo? Have to play Felipe. Hanish has done well in all the positions I've played him in. Have to keep Tonito in. Do I keep Lourenco in? No, he's 93. It was Caraco, wasn't it? Oh, for fuck's sake. Have to play Lourenco on the flank. called Palo something. There's only 5 minutes left, but is he developing? When does his contract expire? 05. I might just offer him a long-term contract. Oh, when I re-sign Jardel, he's got a 15 million fee release clause, but if we qualify for the Champions League, then I think I can just offer more wages then, because he was just under what I could offer, so and he wanted a minimum fee. But there's no point in even actually selling him. It's just waiting for him to retrain as a winger. Always a tough away game. Victor Gudmeres. So we'll play Alfonso there. Even Tonio is suspended. Play Hugo Viana in there. Actually play Hanush. And then play Luis Diaz on the right. Yardell fully fit. Who's my captain? Better. Yeah, we're very weak down the flanks at the moment because of injuries. And suspensions. No. goalkeeper. 4 points behind. Dismissal. I just knew that was going to happen when descending off, especially when we're so weak down the flanks. Quickly check the youth search. Oh, I didn't even reassign them. There's a few. No one. Nothing going on there till next season then. Nelson. But we need to get through this defensive midfielder. Let's go. Paolo Beno. Kazuma is back though. Martin's through the middle. Who do I play down the right? I'll stick with Hanesh. So yeah, Pinto, Nikolai. Anish Diaz, Ruben O, Andre Cruz, Thiago. Cool, good start, and we got the away goal. Oh, no way. We're free though, even if they score. We got some luck this game. Makes up for some of the league games we had. And BMR Stan Gratz, that's a nice tie. Best defenders injured. So who's tired? No one really. Luis Felipe can get taken out for Hanish. Your devil back in. Lead to the on the bench. Start. Bring on some fresh legs now that the game's won. It's mainly the flanks, so Hanush. It's when my mouse gets cool. Yeah, Pinot makes it five. All three strikers scored that game. With Sal Pinot getting two and an assist. He's starting to pick up now. Four goals, five assists. And then Santa Clara away. So I need to check the contracts of the B team. Travessos. Oh yeah, he can just get released. Same with him as well. What about the 18? Yeah, it's all good for now. See, let's check the league table because they've only lost to us so far. This will be an interesting title race. Kind of reminds me of that first season I was PSV and I was trying out a tactic, and Feyenoord just didn't look. Feyenoord basically won every game throughout the season, and because we had a slow start, we never caught them back up. Felt a bit crashy then, so I'm just going to save it. Batto's back. What fit is Batto anyway? He's right. He's playable sometime around, but that's about it. Quagliarella. What's Quagliarella's tackling? I like that he's quick, that's the only thing on the outskirt, on the outside. But I'm going to go for Quagliarella. Because Quagliarella's preferred foot right, and the other dude's right only. Do I keep Paolo Bento in? He's been playing well recently. Or do I put Rui Bento back in? He just doesn't tackle, look. He's purely a playmaker on it. So Rui Bento back in. Bento back as captain. And I think apart from the right flank, that's our strongest. Barbosa is back. Even better. I do want Hanish on the bench for Lourenco. Ricardo George. Yeah, they are. We'll get second before half time. We're so on top as well. This is the problem with the tactic. If we're not like two or three up with when we're miles on top, it's always risky to concede when the AI have a spell. Now they've, so 18. It was Lazaro, wasn't it? Yeah. So I freshen up the flank. Good away performance, actually. I thought Porto lost, but they haven't played yet. Come on, Gil Vicente. Oh, Porto won 6-1. What tactic are they playing at the moment? Fairly strong. They've got Deco in the hole. And they've got, yeah, that's a pretty strong tactic. Are they actually playing out and out strikers? No, forward right, forward left. But he's got left forward in his hidden. Makes sense why they're playing there. Yeah, he's been awesome. 11 goals, 3 assists. Look at his average rating. Especially when he's doing a team job as well with the arrow back. He could potentially develop one day. He's playing well in the B team. Imagine two Yalpinos on each forward centre position. That's how Pino's just not at the same level as him, but he's still good. Yalpino's a complete player, isn't it? He's perfect to play in that slot, Yalpino. But it's like there's not many Yalpinos in the game. When does Jordi expire? Because he's actually, once he's retrained as an AML left, he'd be quite useful as a rotator player if he ever does. Yardell 14 and 12. And I think Nikolai's averaging a goal a game as well when I've used him. Did it say Benfica a second now? The Porto player, no. I thought he said Benfica a second. I was like, what? Guess this is the strongest team, isn't it? Yeah. Let's check Rui Beno's off man mark in this game. Shit again, and injuries as well. Ah. Yardell finally. Two quick goals before half time. We're so dominant, I think I can get away with bringing on some subs. Paolo Beno for Rui. Luis Diaz for Pedro Barbosa. He hasn't been the same since he's come back from injury, Barbosa. Yardell hat trick there. Paulo win again. This title race might go down to the wire. If there's a, there might be like a winter break gap. If there is, then well, it's not that big. I'll play the cup game and then I'll save it. I put Nicolai in and rotate a few players. Keep Sal Pinot in because he's playing really well at the moment. Just change up the subs. I'll change the Beno over. I'll play Santa Maria as well. And I'll play Thiago. Andre Cruz. Beno. Play Luis Diaz this game. Put Hanish on the bench and Yardell. So who's my cup? Yeah, still better. In. Well, the Renko is pretty rounded for such a young player, so I've got quite high hopes. I'm going to check is what he's done so far at half time. Yeah, he can just play that slot nicely. Let's bring on Hanish for Luis Diaz and then swap them over. Should I bring Yardell on? Probably don't need to. I can bring Rui Bento on though. Well, he scored two quick goals. My goalkeeper's again, is it? Played a six. Five. Well, at least it was in a game that didn't matter. Well, didn't matter, but we was already 4-0 up. Anyway, I'll save it for now. We got a run of away games for when we return. So we got Matimo, Razem. There's a lot of winnable fixtures there. Hopefully we can start closing the gap on Porto. Porto aren't conceding goals, which is always a sign that they're going to be strong. They did draw at home to Liera. They drew with us. Anyway, thanks for watching.